Now let's look at one more interesting thing over here. Let's understand what is my F bar over here. Okay, what is F bar? F bar is the complement of F. Okay, so wherever my F is 0, FR bar is going to be 1 because complement of 0 is 1. And wherever my F is 1, F bar is going to be 0. So this is my F bar. Okay, first of all, let me just take these. Whoops, I would like to remove these rights. Okay, now I'm going to fill it up. So this is going to be 0, this is going to be 0, this is going to be 0, and this is going to be 1. Okay, so let me just complete this table for F bar. It is something like this. Now from this table, what you can do is you can calculate F bar in terms of sum of minterms. You can say F bar is equal to M0 plus M1 plus M7. So you can see all those terms which are not in F are in F bar. Okay, I'm going to write over here terms not in F are in F bar. Okay, so now that we have calculated F bar, you can also write F bar in terms of a simple SOP. Okay, M0 is what? M0 is A0, B0, C0. So this is equal to A bar, B bar, C bar. Then M1 is what? M1 is A0, B0, and C1. Okay, so this is going to be A bar, B bar, and C. And what is M7? M7 is A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, C is equal to 1. So this is equal to A, B, C. So this is my F bar. Okay, from the truth table of F, I am also able to derive what is the sum of min terms for F bar and what is the canonical SOP for F bar. Okay, so with this I conclude the topic of min terms. Now I am going to tell you about max terms. Okay, max terms or canonical TOS, product of sums. Okay, what is a max term? A max term is simply a sum that has all the variables present in the expression. All the variables present in the expression. Okay, so let's look at what we have done in POS and find out if that is a canonical POS. Okay, this is my F bar, right? I have reached till here. Okay, so I'm just going to copy this and I'm going to paste it right here. Okay, so what is this? This is F bar and it is something like this. Okay, let's highlight this max term definition so that you do not get confused. Now this is a sum term, but it does not have A, therefore this is not a max term. Okay, similarly this guy does not have C, hence